الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله today we have gathered here in this masjid on the urs the commemoration of the lives of some great personalities. And as Qibla Hafiz Abdul Qadir Sahib has mentioned regarding Sohba companionship. Companionship is a great tradition of our elders, of our Salaf and our Khalaf, our noble predecessors, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. Sohba companionship. If we look at the noble Quran, we look at the stories of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, the stories of the awliya, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we see suhba. For example, in the story of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Sayyidina Khizr or Khadir alayhi salam, what do we see? We see suhba. We see companionship. When Musa alayhi salam requested Sayyidina Khizr alayhi salam to stay with him, what did he say to him? هَلْ أَتَّبِعُكْ Is it possible that I may stay with you, that I may follow you, that you تُعَلِّمَنِي, that you may teach me? We see in their story, صُحْبَة, companionship. When we look at the story of Ashab, the companions of Kahf, or the companions of the cave, what do we see? We see صُحْبَة, companionship. The story of the Hawariyun, the companions of Isa alayhi salam, who were they? The companions of Isa alayhi salam. So company or companionship is a great attribute mentioned in the noble Quran, in the hadith of the beloved sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The greatest of the Muslims, the greatest generation, who are they? The Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Company is a great tradition of our deen, of our religion. Company is what made Mahbub-e Subhani Qutb-e Rabbani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu what he was. We see this in the lives of the great awliya, from the salasil, the spiritual chains. They all became who they were from company. Imam Ahl Sunnah alayhi rahma has made this one of the conditions, and this is one of the conditions of a spiritual guide, that he must have been in the company. He must have been in the company of someone who was in the company of someone who was in the company, eventually leading through that individual who was in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And alhamdulillah, I have been blessed a number of times to be in the company of our Qibla Hazrat Sahib, Khalifa Abdullah Adin Sahib Damat Barakatuhu Al-Aliya, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them a long and healthy life.
Amen.
And we see within them this attribute of the Salaf and the Khalaf. At times I sat with Hazrat Sahib and they mentioned regarding the Sohba that they had with their own father, for example. How their father, whose urs we are today celebrating, commemorating, whose life today we are celebrating, Faqihul Asr, the faqih, the jurist of the era, Allama Al-Had, Mufti Fazl-e Ilahi, Dawat Barakatuhu Al-Aliya, Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. They spent time with them. They had sohbah, companionship with their father. Their father taught them. And this, what you see today, is the athar, the outcome of the companionship they had with their father. But in addition to this, they also had companionship with their great murshid, Khwaja-e Khwajigan. Al-Hajj, Peer Ghulam Muhyiddin Al-Ghaznawi, Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. And you see that this attribute of Sohba is a great attribute. As Ibn Hafsah mentioned, that the awliya, they say that Sohba, the Sohba of a good person, the company of a good person is like sitting with an attar, with somebody who sells fragrance. You will not put fragrance on But what will happen as a result of sitting with someone who sells fragrance is that eventually you will become fragrant. And the example of a bad company is like the example of a blacksmith, somebody who works with iron, like somebody who works in a garage. You sit with them, you do not work yourself, but merely being with them will eventually affect your clothes will be stained, will smell, will be marked. Likewise, the company of a bad individual, that you may not yourself intend to do bad, but eventually this will affect you. Alhamdulillah, in our studies, we are reaching the end of our fifth year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored us for the last 5 years with the greatest honor that I have ever been honored with in my life, to study with our honorable teacher, Mufti Abul Barakat, Muhammad Munawwar Atiq, Naqshbandi, Razwi, Damat Barakatuhum Al-Aliyah. Alhamdulillah, this is the end of our fifth year. In our third semester, we studied this book, Bidayatul Hidayah, of Imam Muhammad Al-Ghazali, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, in the module of Umradul Qulub. This is one of our modules, which is a seldom module, something you will not find in a lot of syllabi. Umradul Qulub, the illnesses of the heart. And within this module, we studied this book, Bidayatul Hidayah, of Imam Abu Hamid, Muhammad Al-Ghazali, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And today, for the remaining time, I want to do is mention some of the points of Imam Ghazali when he speaks about sohba, company. When you see company, when you see company with a friend, he says that there are two matters that you need to look at. The first is in regards to your friend, and the second is in regards to your conduct with your friend. So when you want to select somebody, and you want the suhba with this person, friendship or company of this person, Imam Ghazali rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he says you should look whether this person has 5 attributes or not. How many attributes? 5. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned al-mar'u ala deen khalili, that a man is on the religion of his friend. فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَحَدُكُمْ مَنْ يُخَالِلْ, that every single one of you should take into consideration whom he befriends. So when you have a friend, this is no ordinary thing. This connection between you and this person, this is nothing ordinary, this is extraordinary. And you should take into consideration this friend. Why? Because a person is on the religion, the way of his friend. So now I will mention the 5 attributes Imam Ghazali rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi mentions. So when you want for a friend, for example, you want to be in the company of an individual, look at 5 things. Look at 5 things. Before I mention them, an important point. Somebody who's not your friend is not necessarily your enemy. Because in our mind, it's one of the two. It's either a friend, and if it's not my friend, he's my enemy. This is not the case. A friend here is someone who you spend time with. Somebody whose secrets you know, and your secrets they know. Someone who you would spend much time with. This is a friend. The very first sign Imam Ghazali mentions that you should look for in a friend is aql, intelligence. You should make sure that your friend is intelligent. He says, rahmatullah ta'ala, why? قَدْ يَضُرُّكُ وَهُوَ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَنْفَعَكُ, that if your friend is not intelligent, rather he is an ahmaq. He is not intelligent, he is unintelligent. At times he will try to benefit you, but he will harm you. He'll intend to benefit you, but he will harm you. For this reason, Imam Ghazali says, العدو العاقل خير من الصديق الأحمق, an intelligent enemy is better than a foolish friend. An intelligent enemy is better. It's better to have an enemy who's intelligent than to have a friend who is foolish. The example of this, for example, a husband and wife, they fall out with one another. So what do? They consult their friends. They do mashwara with their friends. A wife will go to her friends. The husband will go to his friends. The friend will always want to do good. But if this friend is ahmaq, is unintelligent, then although they intend good, their mashwara, their suggestions will cause harm. So the very first attribute in a friend that you should look for is intelligence. The second attribute, husnul khuluq. Husnul khuluq, good conduct. Your friend must have good conduct. Why? Well, first of all, he defines the person and he says that a person who is sa'a khuluquhu, someone whose khuluq, whose conduct is not good, is a person la yamliku nafsahu inda al-ghadabi wa shahwa, is a person that at the time of anger he can't control himself. He gets angry and he cannot control himself. Or he is overcome with desire, with shahwa, and at that time he cannot control himself. Imam Ghazali rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi quotes Al-Aqaridi rahmatullahi ta'ala, who at the time of his death gave advice, gave nasiha to his son, and he said to his son that make ishab, accompany or befriend, man idha madatta yadaka ila khayrin maddaha, that if you were to move towards goodness, if you were to put your hand out towards goodness, your friend would aid you in this. Your friend would aid you in this. وَإِذَا رَأَى مِنْكَ حَسَنَةً عَدَّهَا, and if your friend sees goodness in you, then he will consider this goodness. وَإِذَا رَأَى مِنْكَ سَيِّئَةً سَدَّهَا, and if he sees that there is a defect in you, then he will confine and restrict this defect. He'll keep it a secret. He will keep this defect a secret. Number three, the third attribute that one should look at is salah, righteousness. Your friend, you should look at whether your friend is a righteous person or not. It is mentioned that to sit in the company of some fasiq, a person who openly sins or is persistent on sinning, will eventually affect you and you will also move towards sin. If you're in a company of somebody who constantly sins, somebody who constantly backbites, somebody who constantly misses their prayers, then this will rub off on you and this will be normal to you. Missing the prayers or backbiting will be normal. Whereas if your companion is salih, is a righteous person, then what will happen is righteousness will rub off on you. That was attribute number three. Attribute number four is hirs, greed. That you should avoid accompanying or befriending a haris ala dunya, somebody who is greedy for dunya. Somebody who is greedy for dunya. Why? مجالسه الحريص تزيد في حرصك ومجالسه الزاهد في الدنيا تزيد في زهدك. That if you sit with somebody who is always thinking about worldly luxuries, of always delving into dunya, then this will increase in your greed for dunya as well. Whereas if you're sitting with zahid anil dunya, the one who is abstinent from dunya, the one who doesn't delve into the luxuries of the world, his zuhud will rub off on you and increase in your zuhud. So that is the fourth and the final, the fifth attribute is sidq, truthfulness. Never befriend a liar. Never befriend a liar. Make sure that your friend is someone who speaks the truth. Why? The example of a lying friend is the example of a mirage. Why? يُقَرِّبُ مِنْكَ الْبَعِيدُ وَيُبَعِدُ مِنْكَ الْقَرِيبُ. That what is far from you will bring it close to you. What is close to you will make it far from you. This is a lying person. And this is one of the worst attributes to have. So to never befriend a liar. So these were five attributes mentioned by Imam Ghazali: intelligence, good conduct, righteousness, to be hadith fil akhirah, to always be thinking about the akhirah, and number five, sidq. These are five attributes that we should look at within our friends. And the last thing Imam Ghazali mentions is huquq, rights of friendship. The rights of friendship. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned مَثَلُ الْأَخَوَيْنِ مَثَلُ الْيَدَيْنِ. The example of two brothers, or two friends, is like the two hands. How? تَغْسِلُ إِحْدَاهُمَا الْأُخْرَى. One hand washes the other hand. This is company. It's like the two hands, where one hand washes the other hand. This is how friendship should be. Once the Prophet ﷺ came to a tree, he ﷺ broke off two miswaks from the tree, two siwaks from the tree. One of the two was crooked, and the other one was straight. One of the two miswaks was crooked, and the other one was straight. The Prophet ﷺ gave the straight miswak to his companion and used the crooked miswak himself. The Sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, أنت كنت أحق بالمستقيم مني. يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, you are more worthy of using the straight miswak. You gave me the better miswak. You are more worthy. This is for you, Ya Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. To which the beloved صلى الله عليه وسلم replied, ما من صاحب يصحب صاحبا ولو ساعة من نهار. There is not a companion who accompanies a companion. There is not a friend who accompanies a friend, even if it is for a moment in the day. إِلَّا وَسُئِلَ عَنْ صُحْبَتِهِ. Except that he will be questioned regarding his company. Except that he will be questioned regarding his company. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, two people have never accompanied one another except وَكَانَ أَحَبُّهُمَا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أَرْفَقَهُمَا بِصَاحِبِهِ. Two people have never accompanied one another except that the most beloved of the two is the one who is the most compassionate to the other. This is the right of friendship. When you are with your friend, this is also called an ithar, selflessness. Ithar, opposite of selfishness, to put your friend before yourself. So when two friends are together, there are not two people who accompany each other except that the most beloved of the two is the one who is the most compassionate to the other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to find good friends. And if not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us good friends. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us ability to walk in the footsteps of our pious predecessors, rahimahullah ta'ala. Ameen bijahi nabiyyil amin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.